السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Abu Huraira reports Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as saying, if anyone extols Allah after every prayer 33 times and praises Allah 33 times and declares His greatness 33 times, 99 times in all, and says a complete 100, there is no God but Allah, having no partner with Him, to Him belongs sovereignty. And to Him is praise due, and He is potent over everything. His sins will be forgiven, even if these are as abundant as the foam of the sea.
Explain.
This hadith is basically saying we have to say
Subhanallah,
Allahu Akbar, and Alhamdulillah 33 times, 34 times. And then equaling to 100, and then you have to say there is no God but Allah, and having no partner with Him, to Him belongs sovereignty, and to Him is praise due, and He is potent over everything. And if you do this, your sins will be forgiven.
Can you explain more?
So the hadith is explaining the purpose of why we do tasbih after every salah, saying that if we do subhanallah, alhamdulillah, Allahu Akbar, wa say all things, la ilaha illallah, wa la sharika lah, la ilaha illallah, alhamdulillah, yuhyi wa yumeet, wa huwa ala kulli shay'in qadeer. If we say all of these, then during our tasbih, the hadith states that our sins will be forgiven, even if these are as abundant as the foam of the sea. So the foam on top of the sea there's a lot of foam on the sea, it's abundant. Even if our sins are equivalent to that, saying these tasbih after every salah, it expels our sins, even if they were as abundant as the foam of the sea. So the hadith is explaining why we should be doing tasbih, and supports the fact that we should do tasbih after every salah.
What's the reference?
Sahih Muslim. Sahih Muslim, Kitab al-Masajid. باب استحباب الذكر بعد الصلاة وبيان صفته حديث نمبر 597 صحيح مسلم 597
صحيح مسلم 597